When you finish your MIDI sequence and you're ready to export it, the first thing you need to do is freeze your soft synths. Do this by clicking the synth rack view and the snowflake icon. Remember that this will disable all the MIDI tracks and create one audio mixdown of all your parts. You should then go to the console view. Look at the right hand side and you'll see the master output for Sonar. You need to check that this is not clipping or exceeding 0 dB, otherwise you'll end up with distortion on your mix. When you're happy with the level of the track, we need to then bounce and create an overall master image. Do this by going to Edit and Bounce to Tracks. Click OK on the dialog box. You'll find now that Sonar creates a new audio track at the bottom of your sequence, and it's got the same name as the sequence. You'll then need to solo this region, and then click once on it. This will set a grey shaded area on the timeline up at the top of Sonar. This will ensure that when you export your final mix, that it's exactly the same length as your bounce region. Then go to File, Export and Audio. Locate the folder with your work in. Ensure that bit depth is set to 16-bit and sample rate to 44.1K, as we're going to be burning this onto CD. Give your track a name. And click Export. This will create a new mixdown WAV file in the same folder as your project. The final step is to burn this to CD. You can do this by going to the Tools menu and choosing Burn Audio CD. Click the Add Track button and then find the track that you're wanting to burn to CD. In this case, it's the file we've just created. Insert your disk and click Burn CD.